guys, and welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be a brand new project pan, and I'm really excited about this one. This is just something I'm doing on my own. It's not a Pantastic Ladies collab. It's not a collab at all. It's just something that I wanted to do. In 2022, I turned 35, and I wanted to do a finish 22 by 2022 kind of project anyway next year, starting January 1st. And I was thinking, actually, I turned 35 that year. So rather than doing 22, why not do 35 and make it a whole 35 thing? So that is what I'm going to do. I am going to finish it January 1st, but it's still going to be a kind of celebration for my 35th year, if that makes sense. So it starts January 1st, 2021. I'm filming it now so that I can upload some things a little bit early because I've got a lot of stuff starting on January 1st. So the first week of January is going to be full of introductions, but it will start on January 1st. So I won't touch the items until then, and then it will go through until January 1st, 2022, but you'll probably get the finale in December. So that is what is going to happen. It's 35 items to celebrate my 35th year of life, and we're just gonna pan everything, basically. I've written everything down in my notebook. I have predetermined which items I'm going to finish. I was going to do it kind of roulette style, but then I was like, no, because that means I have to go through my entire collection and list everything and then roll the things. I just figured it was easier to pick the items straight out of my collection, and then I know what's my oldest items and I know exactly what I want to work on. So I've written 35 things in my book. You can see it's like a really long list, but I'm just going to read off stuff. I'm gonna go as quick as I can, so please don't feel like I'm rushing it. It's just, there's a lot of things here that we need to get through. So the first 7 items are nail polishes. I only wanted to pick 5 nail polishes, and I wanted to do it like 5 nail polishes, 5 lotions, 5 hand creams, you know, and be really cool about it. Didn't happen. So the first item is an Avon nail polish, and this is the Magic Effects nail polish in Rose Quartz. And this was in a project pan previously. So you can see here, the purple line is where we are starting for that one. The next item is the Model Zone nail polish in Heather, and this is a brand new polish, and I have gone ahead and marked the starting point, and it is this mark just here. The next one is the Rimmel 60 Second Nail Polish in Caramel Cupcake, and that one has been marked as well, and it's just here. The next one is this little mini scented polish. This is the Walls Split one, and this is the mark where we are right now. The next one is an Essie mini, and this is Fiji. And that is where we are starting. And the next one is Glow Your Own Way, also by Essie. And that is there. And the last polish is another Rimmel one. This is Your Majesty. And the starting point is there. So that's all the polishes. Moving on to the skincare then. I have this. You might recognize this from a different project pan, but that one is finished now, so I'm moving it out of that and into this project pan. So this is just some generic night cream. It's got vitamin E in it, but that's all I know about it. The label has worn off, but it didn't have much information on the label anyway, because this was sent to me for testing purposes. And when they send you the things, they don't tell you who makes them. It's just like, so you go in with an unbiased point of view. So that is this one, and this currently weighs 54 grams. The next one is the Revolution Caffeine Solution Hyaluronic Acid Under Eye Serum, and we are currently at this line here. The next item is the Honest Beauty Instant Plump Eye Cream, and we are down to about here, and it weighs 15 grams. The next item is this. This is the Your Good Skin Anti-Shine Base Lotion, and this has been in a previous project pan. We are starting at this blue line here. Then we have some makeup bits. So the first item is this. This is the Lacquer & Co. Cheeky Lip Pencil in Humble Brag. And it is just this bright pink lip and cheek product. I don't use this on my cheeks, I just use it on my lips. It's wonderful, wonderful color. But I still have a little bit left of this that I want to get done. And I will show you against the paper as well. That is where we're starting on that one. And we have another lip product. This is the Urban Decay Revolution Lipstick in the shade Obsessed that I've been trying to get rid of for a very long time, that just needs to get done and out of my collection, basically. That is where we are on this one. And this one is another shade of pink, but this one is more like a lighter Barbie pink, and it is this one here. Ignore the eyeliner swatch, that was from a different video. I've not washed my hands because my hands are really dry and I'm avoiding washing them. Obviously, I'll wash them if I go to the toilet, but I'm not gonna wash them for the sake of washing them. So that is that one. The next item is this. This is the Reserve Your Cabana by Wet n Wild. This also was in a project pan. This needs to basically get out of my collection as soon as possible. I refuse to throw this away because I've hit pan and I repressed it and I hit pan again. At this point, if I throw it away, it feels kind of defeatist. I absolutely must get this done. So that is that one. The next item might feel like a bit of a stretch, but go with me on this one. This is the Urban Decay Moondust palette. I want to use all of it. Now, I've heard from people who have panned this that it doesn't take long to pan at all, and that you could probably pan it in less than a year. I don't know how long it took Amanda, but she said that she hit pan really quickly on these shadows. So I'm gonna give it a go. I'm gonna see what happens. If I don't do it in a year, I don't do it in a year, but it's something to aim for. I do have my Pan That palette, pan those palettes that I have, but these are more like sparkly eyeshadows, whereas the palettes that I've picked for my Pan That palette are more like neutral kind of everyday shadows. So I'm hoping that this will bring in the sparkle side of things when I need it. So that is that item. That counts as one item, by the way. The next item is in the body care section, and this is the Enecto Naturals Lime, Mint, and Coconut Infusion Body Lotion, and this is brand new. We are starting at the silver line up here. The next one is another body product. This is the Body Shop Pina Colada Fresh Body Sorbet, and again, this is brand new, and we are at this silver line here. The next item is another body lotion, surprise, surprise. This is the Avon Faraway Infinity Body Lotion, and it is brand new, but it seems like we're only starting halfway down it. So this is where we are starting on this one. Continuing along the body theme, we have the Champneys Citrus Blush Enlivening Body Lotion, and this is another brand new product. It is at this silver mark here. The next one is the Champneys Body Butter of the same scent, and this is how much we have, and this weighs 59 grams. We have the Soap and Glory Righteous Body Butter. This is another brand new item, and this weighs 67 grams. Now we are onto the hand creams. We have the Soap and Glory Hand Food. This is the Sugar Crush scent, and we are starting at this line here. We have the Mandara Spa Hand Butter, and this weighs 88 grams. And we have the Champneys Hand Cream, which weighs 47 grams. Next up is the Polar Hand Cream, and this weighs 28 grams. And the next item kind of got out of shuffle a little bit. This is the Matas, I think it's pronounced. This is from Denmark, so bear with me. Day cream, this is just a normal skin day cream that I got while I was there because it was really cold and my skin was super dry, and it's never dry, and I was just like, I need a moisturizer desperately. What have you got? And they were like, yeah, just get this one. So that is that, and we're starting here. The next one is Avon Hand Cream. This is the Glycerin Hand and Nail Cream. I love this hand cream, so I feel like this one will go really quickly. Sorry, that one weighs 105 grams. We have another day cream. This one weighs 87 grams, and it is the Superdrug Naturally Radiant Brightening Day Cream. And that is where we are on this one. Next up is masks, and we have the Antipodes Connect with Nature Aura Manuka Honey Face Mask, and this weighs 65 grams. We have the T-Zone Charcoal Peel Off Mask, and this weighs 55 grams. We have the Your Good Skin Purifying Treatment Mask, and that is marked on the bottle here. It is just that mark there. The next mask is the Mario Badescu Strawberry Tonic Water Mask, and we are there. We are about a third of the way done. I will go ahead and weigh it for measuring progress purposes, and that weighs 81 grams. And the last item in the mask category is the Generation Clay Brightening Purple Clay Mask, and this weighs 114 grams. And then we have two items which are in categories of their own. We have the Revolution Purifying Cleansing Paste, which weighs 75 grams, and the last item is a lip balm. This is the Nivea Mango Shine Lip Balm, and it is completely brand new. I will go ahead and mark it on some paper in a bit, but as you can see, it sits flush with the tube. So completely brand new, this lip balm. And that is all 35 items that I want to finish by 2022. Hopefully, I will manage to get all of the items done. I'm aiming to get at least 25 done. So I know there's a lot of stuff here which is brand new, and a lot of stuff which is the same product. So I have a bunch of hand creams, I have a bunch of body lotions, but those are the categories categories that are most prevalent in my collection and the categories that I will be fair and say I use the least of. With COVID, I've been using more hand cream, but that's only this year. Normally, I only go through like 2 hand creams a year. This year, I think I've been through 5 or more. So there is a big difference between what I have in my collection and what I actually use up. That is why there is a big selection here of stuff that is brand new and stuff that is basically just body care and nail polish. That is why this project is mostly body care and less on the makeup side of things. There are some makeup bits in there to make it a little bit more fun, a little bit more interesting, but this is basically just going to be a body care heavy project. I hope you guys enjoyed the introduction for this project. I'm looking forward to starting it. As I said, I've picked these items now, but I won't be starting them until January 1st, and then we will have our first update in February. Thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I will see you very soon. Bye!